Hello guys, and welcome to this tutorial series where I will go through all the thermal mods, we can say. So basically that's the thermal expansion base. Well, it's the redstone flux power system, thermal dynamics, thermal foundation, and so on. So I'll try to go through all of these, and starting with ores and material. And then I'll try to go through in each episode, try to cover a certain theme, so to say. So let's get started. And as always, read more in the video description where I explain more about the pack and lots of other information that might be useful. So except for the normal blocks that we get from the normal Minecraft vanilla, thermal foundation adds quite a few blocks, and as you might know, other mods can also add these. So in some packs you will see only these ones, and in some other packs you might find another variant, but I'm just covering the thermal part, so let's stick to that. So they are copper, tin, silver, lead, nickel, platinum, iridium, and destabilized redstone. We'll come back to that later in another episode. There are two more materials that can be found in thermal mods. It's the aluminum. It's added by thermal foundation, but it's disabled by default. So in some mod packs it might be there, in some mod packs it might be there because of other mods, but its default state is off. And the same goes for the mana infused ore, that is also disabled by default, so I'm not covering that in this series. And when you have broken these, you smelt them, you make ingots, you make blocks. So we can, here are the normal ones, iron, gold, redstone, diamond, and so on. And then we get the tin, copper, lead, silver, and so on. But you also see that there are many more here. Steel, electrum, invar, constantan, and bronze, lumium, signalum, and so on. They are alloys created from machinery. You can't find bronze or constantan out in the world, but we will create that later, but not in this episode. This is only to cover the basics, so to say. But we have all these different materials, and that is quite fun because thermal foundation adds all these different metals and alloys, and adds armor sets and tools to them. They are not all very good. For example, copper and tin are not really that impressive in the amount of armor. Even worse than gold. But diamond is very good, as you know, and it's as good as platinum. The other ones are, well, mostly like iron, I guess. And the best one, save for last, the flux infused one. However, that one will take some time to come, well, we'll come back to that in a later episode. It's not really covered in the basic steps. Tools as well, they are added. Swords and shovel, pickaxes and stuff. Even armor, shears, fishing rod and bows, shields. They work exactly like they do in vanilla Minecraft, but they add more variety to the game. Well, perhaps some more durability, but basically, and I guess the pickaxes, they have different breaking levels, but not better than iron, most of them, I think. But you'll find that in the tooltips telling you exactly how good they are. And you can try for yourself. But mostly, they add variation to the mod, which is always nice. However, there are two new items that are added that are not in vanilla. First, it's the sickle. So let's test it on a tree. So if we are in survival, you can chunk, you can chop off lots of vegetation with a single strike, as with the grass on the floor or on the ground and so on. And the different materials work well, they are better or worse. And the other item that is added by thermal foundation is the hammer. Now, at first I thought this actually was some kind of weapon, and of course it works as a weapon. You can strike with it. It does a decent amount of damage, I would say, but it's quite slow. If we compare to the platinum sword, you can see that the speed is 1.6 for the sword. I think that's the speed. And the hammer is only 0.9, but the amount of damage is much higher on the hammer. So let's try to use the hammer, because it's actually a mining tool. It strikes down a 3x3 area, and it looks something like this. This is a platinum one. I guess it's roughly the same as the diamond tools, and it's very fast, of course. But you need to think about where you aim, because if you strike at a weaker material, like obsidian, I can break it. But when I try to do it from the stone center, it doesn't work. However, doing it from the obsidian center, it will break the weaker material. This is quite common. Oh, I got a lot of diamonds. That's quite common. You've seen it before, probably in other mods. But when you have all the basics, you are actually quite prepared to get started with the machines and the redstone system. So the first thing you should do is craft yourself a crescent hammer. If we take it and you take a look at the crafting, it's not very hard to make. It's probably the first thing that you do, because when you are working with machines and ducts, you pretty much need it. And another good thing is to have a multimeter. It's not extremely useful, but it provides information about things. We'll come back to this in next episode, where we go through, well, alloys, electrum, and the redstone system. So with that, we are pretty much prepared to take the next step, and well, I hope I see you in the next video. Take care, and bye-bye.